Today, we find ourselves in Buffalo, New York. Deep-fried chicken wings were a staple in Southern cooking for many years. But one faded and perhaps fortuitous night in Buffalo, the owner of the Anchor Bar decided to dress up some leftover wings with some hot sauce, and then she served them to her family. And anyone fortunate enough to have sampled the real deal knows how absolutely delicious they are. Now, let's not pretend there is any nutritional value in a large platter of wings with lots of homemade blue cheese dressing. And then, you know what, for some good measure, throw in some celery and carrot sticks. But who cares? They really are that good. I grew up in Hamilton, Ontario. It was just 60 miles to cross at the Peace Bridge and then shuffle off to the Anchor Bar in Buffalo, where we drank OV splits, ate tons of wings, licked our fingers, and drove home. Not necessarily a good idea in this day and age. So today the Saucy Apron is getting really saucy with my version of baked chicken wings tossed with lots of butter and hot sauce. We're also going to do some baked potato wedges and homemade blue cheese dressing. Sit back, enjoy. I know that you will. Hey, how about an OV split? Hello there. Welcome to the Saucy Apron today. Today we're going to do the shuffle off to Buffalo. We're going to do Buffalo style wings, but I'm going to actually bake them. I prefer them that way. Then we'll toss them with lots of butter and some really, really funky hot sauce. We're going to make some crispy potato wedges, sort of take, and again, a baked product, sort of take the place of having fries with this. And then to finish it off, we're going to do a homemade blue cheese dressing served with traditional celery and carrots. So at least we bring a little bit of health into this meal, okay? So basically what I've done is, when we first started buying chicken wings, which probably most of you don't realize, we actually bought chicken wings like this, completely whole. I've already cut up this group and I've got them marinating. So what we're gonna do is I'm just gonna show you how to cut the wing. You basically just take it like this. You find the soft part of the joint and then you just cut through. Okay, so you just want to cut off this, and actually I always save the tip for chicken, actually make chicken stock with it. So you just want to cut through. So we've done two like that. Now this is something that most people probably don't do, but I have to tell you the truth, it's one of my absolute favorites. And when I first started making chicken wings, other than, because I would never deep fry anything, to this day I never deep fry anything. I've never had a deep fryer in my house, never. But what I do love is, and I hate to admit this, but this is the original shake and bake back from the, does anybody remember the commercials when the little girl would say, and I helped? But anyways, this is the original shake and bake. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take two pieces, leave them completely, or two actually chicken wings, leave them completely intact, toss them in my shake and bake, and then all we're gonna do is just bake them. And I guarantee you, they are absolutely delicious. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna move this bowl off. We're gonna take our pot, our little pan to put our two nicely, little two pieces of shake and bake chicken, which will go in the oven. And then the other chicken wings, which actually have been marinated, I'm just gonna toss them a little bit. The few pieces that we actually added into here. And we're gonna put them on a tray and they're gonna go into a 400 oven and cook for approximately about 45 minutes. I usually turn them over after 25 minutes. So anyways, we've got a pan here. I'm just gonna dump the chicken wings on here. Layer them out a little bit. Just to keep them even, I usually actually flip them so that the skin side, the biggest skin side is up, so that you know when you're trying to baste them, where you're coming from. And then they're just gonna go in a hot oven, the shake and bake as well. Okay, so they're just about perfect fit on this pan. I actually have sprayed the pan with a little bit of cooking oil, only just to make sure that not everything really sticks with them, because they can get a little bit sticky. But there we go. So we got the chicken wings put on our tray. We're gonna go into the hot oven. It's a 400 degree oven.
So what we're gonna put together right now is a homemade blue cheese dressing. Personally, what I use is Greek yogurt. Non-fat Greek yogurt. A lot of people use sour cream. Eh, you know what? I don't think you need the extra calories. Let's try to make this meal a little bit healthier than it normally is. So we're just going to use some Greek yogurt. I'm going to use about equal amounts of mayonnaise, approximately about a half a cup of each. Mix that together. Now, I personally like to add a little bit of horseradish. I'm not sure many people do, but I like it. I like a little bit of the heat with it. We've got that. Just mix this up a little bit. Get it together. Again, you want to put just a little bit of vinegar in, because a lot of people will use a buttermilk, and you need a little bit of the acidic in. So I'm just going to put a little bit of vinegar in. That, again, could be, you could add to it if you felt that you needed it. So I'm just going to mix all this up. Again, maybe just a little bit of pepper. I'm not really sure it needs any salt at this point. So we're going to mix that up. And then, of course, the wonderful crumbs, the blue cheese crumbs. So let's put that in. So you want to mix this up really, really good. This is actually better if you were to do this the day before. It always does taste a little bit better. Okay. Might use a little bit of a whisk here just to break up a few of the chunks in the blue cheese. It's nice and thick. And unfortunately, I do have to try it. Just taste a little bit to see. Oh, that's good. Might just add just a little bit of salt at this point. And again, like I say, making it the day before, the flavors actually have a much better chance to meld, and I think the taste is better. So we've got that done, and we're going to serve actually this blue cheese dressing with just some carrot and celery sticks, which is pretty traditional. So I'm just going to put it in the bowl. Again, you know, I mean, everybody has their own rendition of making blue cheese dressing. We are actually just serving this with chicken wings, so it doesn't have to be. You know, if you were going to, let's say, use this on a salad, or some people even serve something like this with a steak, you'd probably want it to be a little bit smoother, mashed up a little bit more. But it is just being served with chicken wings, so I think we're good with the way it is now. Okay, we are actually finished our meal now. We've got our blue cheese dressing, and what I've done is I've just cut up some celery and some heritage carrots for the color. We'll put that up here. Next, we have our roasted potato wedges. Put that right there for you. And the star of the meal, the chicken wings. Yeah, they're not as crispy as normally what you would get, but at the same time, they're a little bit better for you. They've got a really nice hot sauce on them. And the other thing that we have is these are our two shake and bake chicken wings. And I have to tell you, they are really, really good. And again, you can do that in a halt. Anyways, enjoy the feast. Thank you. Thanks for coming to Buffalo with us. For all the ingredients to any of my shows, please go to my website, www.thesaucyapron-taiwanon.com. Thank you. Bye.